right, so just finished up a bunch of work. Actually done with work for the day, thankfully. It's around 3 p.m. now, completed everything. Unfortunately, there's just a lot of problems going on in the business at the moment, but accepting them with open arms and doing everything that I can to tackle them. You know, a lot of people think business is just making money, but no, it's actually solving problems most of the time. So it's just part of the process. It's part of running a business, and it's just things that you have to face. Got some boxing gloves over there, so we're gonna head over to the gym, do some boxing. If it ain't peace, there's no time. If it's for the money, then nigga, I'm online. If it's for the honey, then honey, I'm on crime. If you hear they got me or show me, you gonna cry. Baby, I've been loving you long time. My camera is having a very hard time focusing. I hope this is focused, but we are about to go to the waterfront here in Cape Town. We're going to be hopping on a boat, meeting up with the infamous George. So I'm late. I got to get running. So I'll see you when we're there.
Take a look at who we found.
Come on.
My brother.
What's up, man?
Sunset is hitting right now.
Don't do your little first trap with sunset.
No, this is Cape Town, bro. Yeah, George hit me up yesterday, said that we can hop on this yacht. We didn't charter the whole yacht ourselves, so don't be fooled.
A good day to have a good day.
Good day to have a good day. And we get that tattoo.
A little bit of biting. Never get no biting. Come let you for biting. Come in.
Nah, but for real, bro, like, I feel like I haven't seen a sunset like this in a long time.
To go for Euro Summer. Well, we do, but yeah, let's go.
We'll be there.
Currently heading upstairs to jump in the pool to do an ice bath. Not really an ice bath, but it's winter here in Cape Town at the moment, so probably gonna be just as cold as an ice bath, but I guess we'll see.
What a way to start the day. I've been putting this off for quite some time now. We're doing ice baths and stuff at the gym, but this was a different story. I think just because first it's early in the morning, it's winter at the moment. I just woke up, but it's a great way to start the day. And we had a beautiful view while doing it of some nice houses over there, providing us with some motivation. If you guys follow me on Twitter, you'll see that I'm busy scaling a brand new e-commerce brand, trying to get it to $100,000 profit per month. So obviously with an ambitious goal like that comes a lot of work, so I don't have any time to be messing around. Gonna get stuck right into it now, and it's a beautiful day. Beautiful day to build and to make progress. So let's get into it.
LA Reed, shit was epic. Throw some weed, pop a bean.
Alright, so it is currently about 9:30 at night. Had a crazy day. If you guys are following me on Twitter, you'll see that I've had a lot of problems in my business at the moment. Nothing that doesn't have solutions, but sometimes it just feels like you are destined to fail. I've personally gone through probably the most problems that I've ever gone through in business in the last couple of months, and sometimes it gets heavy, you know. I have a very positive mindset. I always try and focus on the positive, and I got into a very good habit of just brushing off the negative, brushing off problems, keeping my head up, always finding solutions. But sometimes it really just does get heavy, and you start losing sight of that light at the end of the tunnel. And that's kind of how I've been feeling today. I know it's not a good mindset to be in. I know that I'm gonna have to face these problems anyway. I'm gonna have to find solutions, but sometimes it just gets hard. A lot of money is involved, a lot of money being lost. At the end of the day, we are operating in a very competitive market, and life is gonna go on without me. Life is gonna go on regardless of if I decide to let these problems get to me or if I decide to actually tackle the problems and find solutions, you know? I've gone through problems in the past. I've always found a way, and there is only one way, and that is to keep moving forward. There's just no other option. You know, either I overcome the problems or I don't. And if I don't, I go back to living with my parents and having no money. I do, I make even more money, I become even more successful, and I fulfill the purpose that I'm on at the moment. But regardless, we'll get a good night's sleep tonight, we'll wake up, and we'll keep moving forward. Alright guys, so If you're gonna eat any type of chocolate, make sure that it's dark chocolate. This right here is 85% dark chocolate, organic as well, so very nice thing to just, you know, cleanse the palates, give your palates a different taste after you eat food, after you eat something salty, but it doesn't have all of the processed sugars like normal chocolate does. So if you're gonna eat unhealthy, at least go for the healthier option of the unhealthy. Just gonna enjoy the piece and yeah, let it sizzle and dissolve in my mouth. Roll the time lapse.
All right, so we got the barber pulling up. I've been getting him to come to my place recently just to save some time, you know. It's a bit of a mission to go all the way to the barber shop when I can just have him come to my place, cut my hair, get it done. Quick in and out.
Not really a mission, but just finding ways to obviously be more efficient and optimize my time. And this is one of them. Plus he gives me a good cut.
In a party with the pill sniffers, yeah. I'm in the back of the hard hat members, yeah. I'm in the back of the Maybach whippers, yeah.
Yo, so it's a very rainy and cold day today out in Cape Town, South Africa. As you can see, it's raining outside. So, perfect day to build. We're locked in, you know, we've got work back to back to back to back. You know, I've got massive ambitions, I have massive goals that I want to accomplish. And I know that all of that is on the other side of hard work. There's no cheat code in this game. There are no hacks. Most of the time, you just have to sit down and you have to do what you know that you need to do. Just want to show you guys the reality of this, you know. Most of the time, you are going to be doing the boring work. You're going to be sitting down and you're just going to be working day in, day out. So we're going to do another block of work right now. And yeah, it is Friday night, so might go out for dinner, might stay in and work. We'll see how we feel.
It's been 25 years that I've gambled my freedom, should have gone Vegas. Blue or the red pill, what's the odds I come out of it? Yeah. Back and I'm better, they told me don't let up, it's never no pressure.
What's really great about my headspace right now is that I've never been this confident in my abilities to achieve what I want to achieve. And that is because I've shown myself time and time again that I can do it, that I can live a great life, that I can achieve what I want to achieve. Literally everything that I've ever wanted to do has come true. I just feel extremely blessed and extremely grateful. And I think it's important for me to look back and acknowledge these things. It's very easy to take your eye off those things and just look for the next thing, which I've been giving a lot of thought about actually. I don't think always striving for the next thing is bad, because that is what helps you to level up at the end of the day. And that is what gives you fulfillment, leveling up. That's just how we are wired as humans, which is what I've now understood. There's nothing wrong with wanting more, as long as you can be extremely grateful for what you do have.
Okay, so I was just at the gym now and I was doing some boxing. I was about to hit a run as well when my friend Vic messaged me and he asked me if I want to go for a sunset run. So just did two ice baths, feel amazing right now, feel great. And we're supposed to hit a sunset run, but I'm currently watching the sunset go down while I'm waiting for him. So hopefully he gets here in time. Great guy, he does YouTube automation, so we'll speak a little bit more about that when he gets here.
Guy just aired my message earlier today.
What's up?
Tell
him
a little bit about yourself. What do you do?
Bit of a low profile. I do social media marketing, but we have basically an online platform that streamlines your marketing resources. Yeah.
Real quick little promo for the man. I'll invoice you after. And this is Vic, the guy that I was talking about earlier that I was scared that was gonna ditch me.
That's
the guy we pulled through.
Yeah, last second.
All right, real quick, what do you do, bro, for the vlog?
Coaching program, personal branding. Some mafia stuff
in
the weekends.
Yeah, I mean that was self-explanatory, bro. I mean, just take one glass of it.
I'm not in a mood, cause my flight delayed. So I jumped on a private jet and I'm asking a pilot the ETA. Lambo parked on a landing strip. Everyone in my gang and my DJ paid. Where's my man?
Yo, so it is currently Sunday, last day of this week in the life. Chilling with two random strangers right now in my apartment. I mean, they seem pretty cool though. So we're having a good time, waiting on one more stranger to spawn, and then we're going to be heading to Canal Walk to do some go-karting. Where does all this cash come from, Emily? What is going on here?
No idea.
We definitely did not just rob anyone.
Spawned out of my pocket.
Infinite money glitch.
Your network is your net worth. Look down. Look at the people around you, bro.
You chip cash?
Alright guys, so got back from go-karting a little while ago. I've got a big week ahead. I'm planning to really just dial in and focus as much as I can. You know, I'm at the point now where I've achieved a decent amount in my life and I have kind of been stagnant at a certain level, and I'm really craving that next level now. And in order for me to get to that next level, I need to go back to
how I got to this level in the first place. Of course, the exact things that I need to do now are different to get to that next level, but it's pretty much just taking the basic same principles that I was using to get to this level now and just adding on new things that I've learned in order to get to that next level. I actually just wrote out my goals and what I want to achieve on that note right there on my fridge, just so every single morning when I make my coffee, I can read that and I can see it and I can remind myself exactly why I'm working, just to keep myself aligned and keep myself on the right path. I have no backup plans. I just have a trajectory and I have a vision and I have the belief, okay? It says it in the Bible, ask and you shall receive. But you have to have faith. You need to fully believe that that thing will happen. If you don't fully believe that it will happen, you're not creating that reality for yourself, okay? When you believe it, that is when you create it, okay? Your thoughts create your reality. I really hope that this vlog inspired you. I really hope that you enjoyed it. And yeah, more blessings. I'll see you guys in the next one.